Hello everyone, my name is Andrei Marius, and in this Envato Task Plus tutorial, I will show you how to create the spilling sticker text effect in Adobe Photoshop. For this tutorial, we'll use a clean cardboard texture and this rich sun font, both from Envato Elements, so make sure to check out Envato Elements, where with a simple subscription, you get unlimited access to millions of creative digital assets, such as video templates, graphics, photos, fonts, and many more. You can subscribe right now with the link in the description. Let's open Photoshop to create a new document. Select pixels from this drop-down menu. Set the width to 850 and the height to 600. Lower the resolution to 72 pixels per inch and then create your new document. Before we move on with the tutorial, make sure that you have the layers panel and the character panel opened. You can easily open these two panels by going to Window in the menu bar. Now we'll start with the background, so download this pack of textures. Select the first one from this list and simply drag it inside your document. Increase the width or the height to 70% and then press Enter. Moving to the text, remember to download and install this Rich Sun font and then return to your Photoshop document. Pick the horizontal type tool from your toolbar and focus on the character panel to select the Rich Sun font. Set the size to 270 and change the text color to 255, 176, and 0. Click on your canvas to type in your text. Switch to the Move tool and hold down the Shift key to select your text along with the cardboard texture. Click these two buttons to center your text and then double click your text to open this layer style window. Make sure that you move it aside so you can notice the changes as you apply the effects and start by enabling the stroke. Let's change the color to white, increase the size to 35, set the position to outside, keep the rest of the settings as they are, and then use this plus button to add a second stroke. Change the color of this new stroke to 152. 27 and again 27, lower the size to 25, click OK and then right click on your sticker text inside the layers panel and go to convert to smart object. With the smart object selected, let's go to edit and free transform, set the rotation to minus 4 degrees and then press enter. Get back to the layers panel and double click your smart object to open the layer style window. Enable the pattern overlay. Change the blend mode to overlay. Keep the opacity and the scale set to 100% and then click this pattern thumbnail to select your pattern. From this list, let's go to legacy patterns and color paper. Select the second pattern, click OK. And if you can't find those legacy patterns, all you have to do is go to Window in the menu bar, open the Patterns panel, open the flyer menu from this panel, and just go to Legacy Patterns and More. This will add the legacy patterns to your list. Let's close this panel, return to the Layers panel, right-click the Sticker Smart Object, and this time go to Rasterize Layer Style. Continue by selecting the polygonal lasso tool from your toolbar and with simple clicks draw a selection in the bottom right corner of your text about like that. Make sure that you are closing the path and then right click inside it and go to layer via cut. As you can see, this created a new layer with that selection. Double click the name and rename it fold. Open the layer style window for this new layer. Just enable the color overlay and make sure that the color is set to black. Click OK and go to Edit, Transform and Flip Vertical to flip your black layer vertically. And now go to View, Fit Layer on Screen to zoom in on this black layer. press Ctrl minus a few times to zoom out a bit, go to around 200%, and then move your black layer around this point. Before we continue, go to Edit, Preferences and Tools. Make sure that this box is checked, click OK, and then go to Edit and Free Transform. Thanks to that checked box, you can see this reference point. Let's move it around this area. Rotate your black layer like that. Press Enter and return to the Layers panel to reopen the Layer Style window for this fold layer. First, disable the color overlay and then enable the gradient overlay. Set the angle to 128 degrees, lower the scale to 18%, and then click this gradient thumbnail to edit the applied gradient. Double-click this left color stop and enter 183 in all the boxes. Click OK, select this other color stop, keep the color set to white, but set the location to 20%. Click OK, and now enable the inner shadow effect. Keep the blend mode set to multiply, change the color to 0, 30 and 50, increase the opacity to 40%, remember to uncheck this box and set the angle to minus 135 degrees, move these sliders to 15, 0 and 30, and then enable the satin effect. Again, keep the blend mode set to multiply and change the color to 0, 30 and 50. Lower the opacity to 40%, set the angle to 135 degrees, move these two sliders to 35 and 40, select the half round contour, and remember to uncheck this invert box before you enable the drop shadow effect. This time set the blend mode to normal and keep the color set to black. Increase the opacity to 40%, disable the global light and set the angle to minus 150 degrees. Move the sliders to 7, 3 and 20. Click OK, press Ctrl 0 and Ctrl minus to zoom out, and then double click your sticker layer to open the layer style window. Enable the gradient overlay. Change the blend mode to screen, lower the opacity to 40%, set the angle to 120 degrees, increase the scale to 100%, and then let's edit the gradient. Change the color for both color stops to black. Move this one to the right, and then with simple clicks, add 4 more gradient stops. Select these gradient stops one by one and set the location to 90, 70, 30, and finally 15. Double click this color stop and change the color to 126, 126, and again 126. And then double click this color stop and enter 222 in the three boxes. Click OK and OK and enable the pattern overlay. Keep this pattern but change the blend mode to multiply, lower the opacity to 20% and the scale to 50%, and then enable the drop shadow effect. Keep the blend mode set to normal and the color to black. Lower the opacity to 10%, set the angle to 135 degrees, move the sliders to 5, 0 and 5, click OK, and with this final touch, your peeling sticker text effect is complete. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Remember to hit that like button as it helps me know that I did a good job. Subscribe if you aren't already, and don't forget to click the little bell icon to be notified of any new tutorial. If you are looking to learn even more, you can check out some of the other tutorials that Envato Task Plus has to offer. I'm Andrei Marius, and I'll see you in the next video.